Hello, Internet, and welcome back to Ward 47. Thank you for joining us this lovely Saturday evening, morning, whatever time or day or month or year it might be for you. Thanks for joining us here today. We're all very amped to be back because many of us haven't been streaming much over the last couple weeks. Took a little bit of a break. We missed each other so terribly, but we're
with
all
every
really
shot
excited.
So far.
So I'm excited for this energy that we're going to be coming into today with. But first, before we get started, talk about other things we've got going on the channel as we are coming back from our little hiatus. Our next stream after this one will be tomorrow afternoon. We would normally be having Dust Falls Dead, but I think we're going to be doing a one shot in its place tomorrow. We're even playing Fucked Up Little Guys.
We're instead of Dust Ball, because LB can't be with us tomorrow, we're going to play Fucked Up Little Guys, which is a GM round robin no prep one shot by Grant Howitt of Honey Heist and other fames, where you take turns playing as either the protagonist or a fucked up little guy a la Dark Souls.
To set the mood for that, I should also say that after this stream here tonight, Savannah's gonna join me for streaming Dark Souls 3, which I haven't played since it came out. So that should be really fun.
We're going to do Dark Souls.
To get back into it. So
I'm going to provide color commentary.
I'm going to fold my laundry and watch you guys play a video game.
Yeah.
And also probably some help, because I've interacted with Dark Souls 3 much more recently than you have.
Yeah. No, that's probably true. That's what we'll be doing after the stream tonight. But join us tomorrow for Tabletop. We'll be playing that. It's going to be a lot of fun. And then the rest of the week should be a normal schedule. Strixhaven on Monday. The Tabletop Tuesdays crew will be back on Tuesdays. I don't know what game we're playing this week.
Do you know what week it is this Tuesday? If you don't,
Squire Squad.
I think it's Squire Squad.
Yeah. What? God. Yes. Yes. Correct.
Sorry, okay. As all of us started talking at once,
I was like, that was the worst thing to ask me, because it's all like, do you know what week is this Tuesday? And I'm all like,
yeah,
that doesn't make any sense.
It was a bad
and also
it was a bad question.
So bad for me.
That's fine.
I'm gonna say that one was on me.
Everything else, if you want to see the full lineup of the shows that we've got going on here on GGK week to week, you can scroll down below our faces if you're watching us live on Twitch, or if you're on YouTube some point in the future, head over to our Twitch page and see whatever we're doing right now, because who knows what that will be. I think that's it as far as announcements go, so I'm going to go ahead and turn things over to my... I see a hand.
It's Escape Velocity next week.
It's Escape Velocity.
Damn, we all fucked it up.
Yeah.
We all messed up. You can join us for shows. We'll be here. Join our Discord, Twitter. You can see when we're going live and what we're going to be playing. Let my players here introduce themselves, talk about what they do on and off this channel, and who they are playing tonight, starting with Savannah.
Hello, it's me, your fucked up little guy, Savvy. I'm at Savvy Seaworth on the internet. It's mostly on Twitter, where you can find my streaming schedule pinned to the top of my page. I'm on this channel Thursdays through Mondays, either playing in games or running them. Like Val mentioned, tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern time, we're gonna do a one shot of Fucked Up Little Guys, which I'm really excited about. We get to play a bunch of Dark Souls NPCs and draw a map and do some. You get 4 GM brains from this channel are gonna be sharing a game tomorrow, because it'll be me and Balance and Alex, so that'll be a fucking blast. I'm very excited. Come watch that. And then Monday nights, the Queer Chronicles of the Strixhaven Quartet, we'll be back for Dungeons and Dragons. That's 8 o'clock Monday night, which I'm also very excited about, because we're about to do a fashion show. And it's going to be awesome. Sunday is going to be Galaxy Brain Day. As Chad says. And then on Sunday nights, you can find me on twitch.tv/LBHackemUp playing Dungeons & Dragons. But tonight, I am playing Aiden Kuto, who is not a fucked up little guy. He is a well-meaning himbo who loves all things art. And sunflowers.
Yeah, that's me.
Hey, everybody. I'm RJ, another fucked up little guy. And you can catch me, RJSS2A2, on Twitter and Twitch, where I tweet about the nerdy things in my life. And sometimes play games with my friends. You can catch me in like three places on the internet so far. Mondays and Sundays over at the Indoor Adventures, where we do Wild Beyond the Witchlight on Sundays and D&D 5e homebrew campaign on Mondays. Thursdays for Elegant Creatures here, and of course Ward 47, we'll talk about that in a second. And then finally Sunday mornings over at the Hype Goblin, where we do another D&D 5e campaign. My bard is going to propose to his girlfriend. I think y'all should come in for that. But today I'm playing Yu, who is a physically fucked up little guy. And he was literally raised by wolves.
And then it's me. Hey, I'm Christina Sid, a averagely heighted fucked up person emotionally. Hey, you can find me on the Twitters at Greek Sid, generally talking about TTRPG shenanigans. Yeah, I'm here again because we're back on the D&D stuff on Mondays, Thursdays through Mondays. Thursdays, I facilitate our game of Elegant Creatures. It's mostly Monster of the Week, but we kept all the fun stuff from Good Society. Whoa, buddies. Thursday was a doozy. And I'm very excited because I think we're about to finish up this mystery. Should be lots of fun. And hopefully we save Leah's girlfriend. Yeah, otherwise, today I will be playing Amaris Brennan. She's an observant, cynical wallflower with an eye for technology and poetry.
Hey everybody, I'm Wings. Also known as Danae Keener. You can find me at DanaeKeener.com or at Danae Keener on Twitter. I've got a pinned tweet there with schedules so you can see all the games that I'm in. Go check it out. Super cool. Super great. Today, I'm going to be playing as Mori, who is a faceless career man with a dream.
DanaeKeener.com.
DanaeKeener.com. And then it's me. Hi, everybody. I'm Val. You can find me at the Kraken's Crown on Twitter and Twitch. I'm here Thursdays through Mondays playing and running games. Other than this game, I co-facilitate our game of Neon Gods on Fridays, which unfortunately we're not able to play this week due to some out-of-game stuff, some real-world stuff. Everybody's good, but we should be back next Friday, I believe.
If not, the next week for sure.
Yes, I also stream over on LB. Yeah, I also I'm over on LB Hackamore's channel Sunday nights, playing in Play Things with the Gods as well. That's me. Y'all ready to get started?
Fuck yeah!
Okie dokie. Then let's do it. Previously, on Ward 47, 4 days were left until your arraignment, all of you still dealing with legal troubles, being framed for the attacks in Ward 47 being carried out by the Silence. You had been in the process of gathering information, trying to exonerate yourselves or get the case thrown out against you, and had set your sights on infiltrating a Silence meeting at a weapon supply shop called Barrel Armory in Ward 48. You had gathered some listening and camera listening devices, cameras from your attorney, and went undercover as part of this meeting with you, Aiden, and Mori attending the meeting, and I just forgot your character's name, Sid.
Amaris.
Oh, no. Amaris, damn it. That's why I was going to take 2 weeks off. I want to save Amelia.
I'm sorry. I will change it appropriately in
I was relying on Zoom. I was looking at everybody's names on Zoom just to get them quick, and
I fucked up. Saw yours. My bad.
Yeah,
my bad.
You ruined it for everyone. I'm just kidding. Mars was on Overwatch outside. You had gained some pretty good video of some of these masked individuals conspiring to carry out another attack in Ward 47, and had actually spoke with the kind of ringleader of this group, who went by the moniker F, pretending to be working for Memento. You had after this brief conversation, you also recorded a audio transcript of this man as he was heading to his car outside of the meeting place, where Aiden, through some clever use of his listening device, or it was the Bluetooth device, I think, that Aiden had, kicked it
That's
across
the
ground.
That's the first time
in
his entire life Aiden's been called clever.
I know. It was clever, though. Threw to the feet of this guy and got some of the phone call that he had been having after the meeting, where he talked about being confronted by a Memento, seemed to be talking with somebody who might have been helping him plan or maybe bankrolling this operation. It was vague, but clearly indicated maybe something else, something larger at play. Afterwards, you threw himself in front of the man's car, pretending to be hit by his vehicle, so he would come, he could step out, and you could get some good video footage of him to identify. You also faking this insurance scam, essentially got a check from this man and identified his name as Elijah Fowler. You had after he left, heading to wherever he lives, most likely, you were all attacked by a incoherent, two incoherents, actually. One of them got a pretty good hit, I think, on you specifically. Am I right in remembering that? You took a pretty nasty blow from the incoherent, and then the attacks were stopped by a third individual that showed up, identifying herself as NA, who you identified as probably also incoherent but had more of a human-like form in comparison to her two compatriots. Had a conversation with your group. I think Aiden speaking with NA at length afterwards, wanted to get a little bit more of information on this, who they are and their group. She used the term or used the moniker The Spoken and asked if you had heard something, and being very vague, or at least not explaining much of what she meant, but told you to come back to her once you had been spoken to. Four of you returned back to Ward 47, though not together, you leaving on his own, and Amaris running off scared. Eventually, Mori and Aiden were able to find Amaris, kind of smooth things over a little bit, and then found you in the park. And I think that's where we left off last time, because you was at the, like, hiding in the park in like, one of the slides or something.
Right underneath one of the slides, just curled
under
up.
Under the slide!
Yeah, it was curled up under there, where the three of you found him. And we're just going to pick up right there.
Uh,
think that Mori had put Amaris on bandaging Aiden's arm because he had forgotten to do that. And Mori's just gonna like quickly make sure that you is like physically okay.
Snoring softly.
All right.
Do you want to try? Does Amaris want to actually do a medicine check here? So I don't think we did that last time, did we?
I have one wound left.
You do. You has how many wounds right now?
I believe. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 wounds.
Oof. Yeah, we could try that.
Would that would that justify or necessitate what's the word I'm looking for? Would that call for taking him to the hospital?
So he has wounds. He doesn't have any health damage at this point. So I don't know if you're at a hospital level of harm. I'm trying to pull up the part about healing in the book.
As long as there's no blood, they're fine, right?
All the bleeding is internal. That's where it's supposed to be.
Yeah, I think that was said last time too, which is yikes. So medical treatment. Yeah, so you can recover. Let's see. So on your own right now, it's intelligence medic check. You get to recover one card from wounds per every two successes to a maximum equal to the draw of the check. So I would say with the level of injuries right now, again, with no health damage, it's probably mostly sprains, scrapes, and bruises. When you take health damage is really, I think, more of the like my arm's falling off sort of damage.
I'd just like to tell everyone, you can't do anything except physical stuff.
Plus,
all of his other things are wounds.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to start off this scene by using my public speaker trick. Okay. I essentially, like, Mori, like, gives a few orders, sort of like, Amaris, you help out Aiden. I'm gonna go check on you. And you're gonna get an additional card to one check in this scene towards healing and taking care of people. Like, a goal. The goal is to, like, get this group back into working order. So that's that. Aiden could also get that. Technically, you could also get that. Bleh. I barred at you. And I'm going to see if there's anything that I can do for you here. And if not, I'm gonna, like, nudge him and see if he is a light sleeper.
Oh, there's just a hand that immediately, like, grabs your leg.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey. Easy now. You all right, you?
Mori?
Hey there, buddy. Can you walk?
That's how I got here, yes.
Well, that situation could have changed. Why don't we stand up and get somewhere with a roof?
You nods his head and uses the slide to pull himself up.
Mori will, like, shuffle and, like, just, like, go right up under his arm and help support him.
Does Bark have, like, a gazebo or something? Like, with picnic tables?
Cast magic missile at the gazebo.
I'd say there's a couple of tables and a rundown merry-go-round that is completely out of use, has like vines kind of growing up the side, which a lot of people use to like sit and picnic during the day.
All right. We'll sort of shuffle you over there and sit him down somewhere comfortable. Mori's gonna try and treat his wounds. We've got a med kit, right? That gives
yes,
us a...
you purchased supplies last time, which I think gave you a plus one. So it gives you one, you add one to your successes.
All right.
So we'll Mori's making the medical treatment check.
Yes.
Could Amaris help?
Yeah, so you guys can assist.
Can Amaris? Oh, wait, okay. I think we've both got the same medic skill. It's two,
right?
Also
intelligence medical, right?
Intelligence medic. Yeah.
Oh, so but your intelligence three. Is better than mine. Yeah.
Yours
well, no,
three.
Actually, minus three as well.
Oh, mine's yeah. four.
What?
Aiden?
What? How?
I have three in medicine.
Oh, and one in intelligence.
There you go. Incredible. Okay.
Oh, all right. Good at something.
Yeah.
Well,
you just like keep everybody so calm and chill that, like, you know, they don't freak out. It's
I also good. Don't have as many smart people cards, probably, but.
That's a good point. You're going to be trying point, to actually. Draw. What is the medic skill?
That'd be aces, heads? Right? That'd be spades.
Spades? Yeah, I was like, not aces.
No, that's
spades
me.
Are intelligence.
Remember,
right?
It's spades for intelligence because you're the sharpest tool in the shed. That's
yeah, exactly. Oh, I was like, what was go. The mnemonic again?
Yeah, so you're going to want to be drawing intent.
I mean, I have here. Some.
Yeah. But that is a good point, though, is that, you know, you'll be able to draw more cards, mm-hmm. but you might not have as many intent cards in your yeah. deck.
I might be able to force a success out of you.
Yeah, and everyone will be able to, you can contribute and try to help with this too, yeah. which means
for
you get
success
to draw two
out of
cards
you.
And add it to the tray. Which I, what is the word on your speech? Because you get to draw an extra card?
You get an extra card, yep.
Does it say specific, like what is the language on it? Because I was
grant
curious whether you...
Or grant an additional card to your allies as your words of encouragement bolsters their confidence and helps push them farther. Hold on, let me read further up. At the start of a scene, if you have spent time to rile up and guide others, you may grant them bonuses toward a goal of your choice. These bonuses apply only for a single check for every listener that pursues the stated goal.
I will also say, my deck does have a bunch of diamonds in it.
Yeah, so you could also do some potential
yeah.
stuff too.
Yeah, we are about to sleep, so.
yeah, so it's whoever wants to do it, it's up to you. I think you could draw an extra card if you're making a teamwork check. Considering, I'm assuming that the goal that you were inspiring, that you're inspiring everyone towards, is healing you.
Yes.
Okay.
You the character, not myself.
You the character. This is
everybody drink. RJ did a chaos again.
It's everything he ever wanted.
Wait, the Nazen on the drinking game too? Fuck y'all.
They did right, the same shit on Thursday. So who wants to do the primary check for this?
I could argue for literally anyone doing this.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're talking character wise, Aiden would probably just bust in and be like, I got you, buddy.
Yeah. I think that Mori like keeps on just identifying wounds and like not really knowing exactly what to do with it. And he's like, he's too like ginger with you and like indecisive. And so eventually Aiden just like swoops in.
It's
like,
fine. I know how to treat this one. You scoops a bunch of dirt off the ground.
No. Amaris is just like holding back Yu's hand every time he tries to put dirt on it. That's
gonna
Mars
get infected.
Almost starts to lick one.
So Aiden, your draw is naturally 4. It's going to be 5 because of Mori's assistance.
Okay.
Because of public speaker.
Because of public speaker.
Can I stack an assistance on top of a public speaker?
Well, so yeah, you'll be able to, all of you can use the teamwork. I'll let you all use a teamwork check here. So Mori and Amaris, you doesn't have to. I think but if Mori and Amaris like narratively are helping, the two of you can do a teamwork check. You can draw 3 cards because of public speaker. And you're trying to draw based on Aiden's draw, which is a 5.
Okay.
Also, cold reading, pull a card and decide whether or not you want to keep it.
Go to the bottom of your deck if you don't.
Okay. I did just get a 3 of spades and 2 diamonds, if that's helpful.
So that's 3 successes. If you don't want to spend the potential there.
Oh no.
I drew an absolutely buck wild amount of diamonds though, so I think we're good. And a spade.
Okay, do you want to spend some potential?
So I've got a 3 of spades.
Okay, so that's 6 successes.
And I will spend a diamond.
Do you want to see so the most successes you can get right now is 5. You have 3, or sorry. You have 6 successes right now, which means you can heal 3 wounds. The most wounds that you're going to be able to heal right now is 5. Do you want to see what Mori draws first, because before you spend any potential?
Sure.
Because if Mori gets 4 more successes, then you're maxed out already anyway.
So. Okay.
We shall see.
Yeah.
Oh. Bing bang boom, baby.
There you go. Got okay. 5.
Mm. Keep so drawing because you might critically fail.
Oh yeah, you should check to make sure you don't critically fail. Well, you can't critically fail right now. You can critically succeed.
Do I like do a full check?
You draw your 3 cards.
Okay.
This isn't if you draw 3 of the wrong suit, then you fail.
Yeah, it's not.
Yeah, but a spade is the right suit. So.
Oh yeah, because you're drawing 3.
Okay, so you're good there. So that's 5 more successes. So you cap out at the 5 wounds healed.
Okay.
Did you draw, Aiden? How many of the wrong suit did you draw?
Are diamonds counted as wrong?
Wrong, yeah.
Because I drew a couple of diamonds and a heart.
How many diamonds?
2. A couple.
2, okay. Then you're fine. As long as you don't draw 3 of the same incorrect suit.
3 of the same wrong suit, yeah. No, I have 2 diamonds.
Well, is it 3 or is it all of the same wrong suit? Now I have to remember.
It's 3.
Yeah, 3 or more cards revealed of the same incorrect suit.
Yeah. No, because I drew a spade, I have 2 diamonds, a heart, and then a joker.
Okay.
Not to draw this out further, but if the incorrect suit is diamonds and then you're spending those diamonds to make a success, are they incorrect anymore?
I think we've talked about this before. Yeah.
I'm fine though, because yeah, I only drew 2 diamonds.
Yeah, you only drew 2. So we're good. But yeah, I think we ruled it last time that if you spend it to change one of them, then that would negate get you that. Out of a critical failure. Yeah.
Cool.
We did it.
At least that's my ruling of it. So yes, you can take 5 cards from your wound pile and recover them, so you can put them in your discard.
Oh, they go to my discard?
I think so. Well, so
the scene's gonna resolve anyway, so I should be
concentrated. Yeah, it's gonna resolve. It'll be fine. Yeah. And we're at a low intensity scene, so I don't really think it matters.
We can reconstitute too. Okay, cool.
Yeah. Alright. So probably taking the next like 30 or 45 minutes to use the health kits, the bandages, the hydrogen peroxide,
and just
everything
straight up resetting a shoulder.
Yeah, and really, because you got hit by the boulder. Rock was the boulder that got thrown. Yeah, so yeah, you're able to patch. You have obviously not you're not in perfect condition. I think you still have 4 wounds. But you are doing much better than you were before. All right.
Well, you are super lucky. Nothing's broken.
Thanks for patching me up.
I'm just glad that you're okay. We need to talk about how everyone just scattered after all of that. Like, I couldn't find any of you.
I mean, in my defense, I stood in one place for a long time.
Amaris takes down her veil and puts it over her face in response.
I mean, I understand being scared. Just, if you guys ever run off like that again, just, like, text me or something. I really kicked myself if anything happened to any of you guys.
Yeah, you.
I don't have a phone.
That's completely fair.
We should get you a phone.
Yeah, we should probably do that.
We could just get like a track phone or something. Like with the card minutes. Is that still a thing?
Yeah. I know that makes sense. Thing, right? Yeah, you know what? I'll take care of it. Let's all get to our respective sleeping places.
Should I send all that stuff over to Penny?
Yeah, that's a yes.
If you want to,
he walks over.
Come back. If you guys want to come back to my place, you can. Amaris, I'm sure Jules will let you use her computer again.
Okay, cool.
And I'm hungry.
Mori said, "Let's all go to our respective sleeping places." You is walking towards the slide again.
Do you sleep here?
Only on Saturdays.
What happens on Saturdays?
The watch doesn't come by.
Do you want to crash on my couch?
Oh, it's not that I'm homeless or anything. I just like being out in the open.
I got a little balcony.
So this is a...
Say no more. You just like looks over at Aiden. His eyes go wide. You have a balcony.
I mean, it's pretty small, but I'm pretty sure I could fit like a sleeping bag out there if you wanted.
He's already at your side.
Okay.
All right.
Mori, I'm running out of space, but I'm pretty sure you could sleep on the couch if you wanted.
Oh, no, it's okay. I have a bed, and also I got some calls that I need to make tonight.
Yeah, that sounds way better.
I'll make sure that you guys all get back to Aiden's place okay, though. If you don't mind.
Can we stop for food?
I really want noodles.
There's a bow
Pretty
place
sure
that's
there's
open
a noodle
right
place
now.
Open at this hour.
Cool. Oh,
yeah, he's gonna nod his head.
Use your noodle is 24 hours, yeah. They're open 24/7.
All right. User noodle it is then.
Yeah.
And hey, good news is, once we get all that information to it's been 2 weeks and I've forgotten
Penny.
The names.
Penny.
Yep. But he would call her by her last name.
Baird.
Yeah. Once we get the information to Miss Baird, we should be able to put all this behind us.
Why do we all remember just this one woman's name? No one else.
She's so cool.
I'm just happy I created an NPC that had that much of an impact.
She's very cool. She's
well,
like,
Penny's
she's
easy
super
because
nice.
in this game we've been talking about Penny for the last several years or something.
I did snag that name. Okay, so you all head over to User Noodle. Slowly, obviously you still recovering. While everybody is putting their order, getting their food, Amaris, you sent over the documents, probably like a link with everything that you've saved and uploaded on a drive in the cloud. I'd say probably about 10 minutes or 15 minutes after you said that, but around the time you're getting to the shop, you get a text back from Penny that says received, let's meet in the morning, come by anytime. However, as you're getting your orders, Penny, you get a phone call.
Oh, shit. Hold on a second, y'all. I gotta take this.
She goes into a corner, covers her face with her veil, and then puts her phone up to her face.
You pick up the phone, looking down, you see that Roanna is calling. You go, Roanna or Roanna?
Roanna.
Roanna, okay. Is calling, and as you pick up the phone, it's a moment of silence. She says, I'm assuming that's you, Amaris?
Well, yeah, but there's a guy named you here too, so that's confusing.
Okay, where are you right now?
I'm in Ward 47.
Why?
I called Mom. It's a long story.
Yeah, she's kind of freaking out here. She said something about legal trouble, and she's been trying to hire attorneys, and
we got one pro bono. We've been working with them. I think it's worked out and stuff, so don't worry. Okay,
do you need me to come by?
No.
Y'all in the back, that's the loudest you ever heard of Mars talk. Just saying no.
I'm just saying, I can swap out my shift at the clinic tomorrow, and I can come by and bring you anything you need. Like, if... Why didn't you call me about this?
I didn't want to get you involved. It was kind of scary, and there's some details that I didn't want to get you mixed up in.
You need to get a job outside the ward.
Yeah.
Listen, I get it. I don't think... I don't believe as much in the fear-mongering sort of bullshit that's going along. I know there's a lot of good people and stuff in Ward 47. It just seems like something bad there is happening, like, every day. So, I'm worried about you. And you're... You could get a job working anywhere. You don't have to work at a coffee shop.
Coffee is what unites us all in this terrible, terrible place.
Yeah, you said that before. I'm not really sure what you mean by that.
It's a solid industry. Everyone is always going to need caffeine. What's wrong with that?
Right.
Okay. Look, I'm sorry I didn't call, but I know you're busy, so I didn't want to bug you at work. I know you've been working a lot of doubles. I told Mom what's up. I'm hoping that, like, tomorrow I can come home.
Okay. You know that I'm never too busy for my sister, okay?
Yeah.
I'm glad that you're working everything out. I know you're an adult and you can handle your own stuff, but I'm just worried about you. You've changed a lot recently, and...
Well, you know why that is.
I know. But I also know that it doesn't have to rule your life.
And how would you know that, Roanna? You have no idea what this has been like. I don't care how many people you've treated or whatever, or whoever you know or whatever. You have no clue, okay?
You're right. I don't.
Sorry. I'm tired. I'm hungry. And my noodles are here. So
right.
I'll keep you in the loop. But hopefully, like, everything's fine tomorrow. Okay?
Okay. If you need me, text me, okay?
Yeah. Cool. All
right. Love you.
I hate you the least.
I'll take it.
Bye.
Bye.
Amaris doesn't turn around. I'm assuming, like, she's in the corner. And there's, like, the alcove for the bathroom, like, over here. She literally just, like, shuffles with her face facing the wall toward the bathroom alcove and then walks in and goes to the bathroom and closes the door.
Her noodles are gonna get soggy.
Welcome back.
Maury's just face first in noodles.
Same. I love this place.
Yu has, like, a very, like, screwed up look on his face, and then he, like, reaches over for the bottle of sriracha and then puts in, like, the big spoon again, and he stares at it. You will not beat me.
You should try it. Oh, okay. You could put it on stuff. It's way better that way.
Takes the bowl of ramen, brings it to his lips, and just starts downing the broth.
Hey, we all do things our own way.
It's all gonna end up in the same place.
It is spicy. That's what's good about it. Oh, man. Have you ever had Tabasco?
I don't smoke.
We'll try that one next. It's also a sauce.
I think I killed the snake.
I don't smoke.
That's fine, good. You shouldn't smoke. It's way bad for you.
After about 10-15 minutes, Amaris returns with her veil down and quietly eats her noodles.
Everything okay?
Yeah. It was my sister.
Cool.
Sure. Noodles.
Sure you're gonna be happy to see her again.
Yeah. Me and my mom and her still live in the same house, so.
Oh, that's dope.
Sometimes.
I wish I had a sister.
Do you like living with your family, or itching to get out of the house?
It ebbs and flows, I guess. It's nice knowing they're okay. But when they're around so much, it means I have to talk to them.
Yeah, we all need our alone time.
We're all always alone.
Yeah, I get a lot of that.
I'm never alone. I have me with me. Underneath the hoodie, there's a little fox head. No, we're in public.
Oh, hey, buddy.
Some ways, where none of us are ever alone.
Yeah. I guess that's true now.
Nope. Speaking of alone time, I really do need to go make those phone calls before it gets too terribly late.
Okay. Is there, like, anything else you need us to do or anything?
Just get home safe. And no more crimes tonight.
Cool.
Can we jaywalk?
We planned this community to be completely walkable. Like, jaywalking doesn't exist.
Why does Ma tell me not to jaywalk?
If anybody ever tries to write you up for jaywalking, let me know. And I'll have them written up for making up a fake rule.
My dad is Mori.
All right. So Mori's heading back home, and the rest of you are going to Aiden's place to sleep for the night.
Yeah.
You sleeping out on the balcony?
Yeah, my brain went stupid for a second. I said, oh no, Aiden and you are the Morden sons. Because we're Mori's sons.
What is it like inside your head, RJ?
What color is the sky in your world?
It is both noisy and quiet at the same time.
Oh god, I feel that way too hard. Anyway. Yeah.
Is there anything?
Let's do the fork in the garbage disposal. Ding, 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 ding.
Is there anything anybody is doing before your meeting with at ABC Law tomorrow?
Texting her mom, but just the regular mom stuff of like, hey, checking in, I'm fine, and then
yeah,
all that, since her sister gave her a hard time.
Oh shit. You just like quietly pokes Aiden's arm and asks for his phone so he'd call Ma and tell her that he's all right.
Just a lot of on the other end of the line. Just,
no, I'm staying at a friend's place. They're cool. They do all the graffiti around the place. Yeah. Yeah. All right. I'll come by.
All right.
Goodbye.
Masterful.
The best dialogue we've done in this game. When I don't feel like playing an NPC in that moment.
I really need to keep that in my back pocket.
Every NPC, when I don't feel like playing them, turns into a parent from Peanuts.
This NPC is actually just Chewbacca.
Chad says, I didn't know Blue from Blue's Clues was here.
We jump into one of Aiden's graffitis.
Here's the mail, it never fails. It makes me wanna
live. It's a where
to go. Alright, are we good to skip to your legal conference tomorrow?
Yeah, I think so.
No. I need to research on why I need to try and track down this fake memento.
Quote unquote.
Okay.
I don't know how exactly I'm gonna do that. Either like making some phone calls to some guys and being like, hey, you wouldn't happen to know if Memento got into contact with the Silence recently.
I'm debating something.
Either that or just like putting out some feelers to see if there's been like movement in the underground.
Come on a journey with me for a bit. I think you're gonna get some of the answers you want. Yeah.
Okay.
let's do the law meeting. Because I think this is maybe gonna help with some of that. So
okay.
If there's something else you want to look into or research, but with the memento stuff.
I think that would be his first priority. Like, he's curious about the incoherence as well.
Let's say you put out some feelers with that, you know, but it's late.
He just makes some calls and, yeah, like, gets nothing back, like, as of now. But, like,
yeah,
there's people sniffing.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm good with that. If there's more information you want to get after I give you some of the bits that I'm going to, but I think this is going
to help. I am happy to go on this journey with you. Let's go for a ride. Perfect.
All right. Everybody buckle up. Tomorrow, the next day morning, everybody wakes up. I assume some of you sleep in a little bit considering you were up pretty late and got pretty bruised up. I think Aiden, you lose your last wound.
Yeah.
You're back to full. You'll recover one every 2 days. So not today, but tomorrow.
And anything in our discard can now go back in, yes?
Yeah, you have ended. New scene ended. You can recompose your deck. Which, actually, I think you can do. You can do another extended check for medical treatment today if you wanted to. But we can wait if you want to do that.
Also, we did eat, so get back a point of potential if you used any.
Yes, you did eat.
Thank you.
So gain potential and perseverance if you can.
Oh, yeah.
You recover a syllable if you're down any syllables because you slept.
Just 1 point of each of those?
Yeah, and so for meals, it's each meal you eat, max of 3 for day, it's 1 potential and perseverance.
Okay, cool.
And then sleeping, you get back 1 syllable each time you sleep. I don't remember if y'all were down any syllables. Because I think you had slept since your test parse. So, recovering all of that, and yes, you can make, like I was saying, you all of you can make an attempt to, or whoever wants to, can do some more healing on you at some point during the day, if you want. But natural healing will take its course over time. I'm also trying to decide at what point I say you run out of medical supplies and when you need to go. You have now healed 2 people with the supplies that you got the other day, Mori.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't really feel like tracking it. It's fine. We'll just say you have it at this point. There's no currency or anything, so I was trying to figure out if it would actually do it, have any narrative benefit. If we ever end up in a situation, I'll say that you continue to restock unless we're ever in a situation where you can't. So
I mean, when it comes down to it, it's like if I like run out of medical supplies, I go like, huh, I better go grab some medical supplies on the way home.
Yeah, I just assume Mori's gonna run by the Walgreens and grab some stuff. And,
I think it would be more of a like a consequence for failure in a intense scene. Yes. So like, oh no, you lost your medical supplies.
Yes. Yeah. I see that. So for right now, y'all are fine. You all meet at ABC Law after having breakfast and find the front desk clerk, who I don't remember what their name was. I did not write it down, but the paralegal that works at the front desk ushers it into the conference room. And after a few minutes, Penny comes to meet all of you. I assume everybody is here. Anybody raise your hands if you're like, I'm actually suspiciously late or something right now. But all of you have arrived. Penny comes in, with a big stack of, files and documents and things and, pushes in and says, "Morning, everyone." Pushes the door behind her. You all look tired. Very tired. Do you need coffee?
Always.
Actually, do you have green tea?
Yes.
I'll take a tea too, please.
Do you want hot tea or cold tea?
Hot
tea. Okay. Puts it down. Hits the conference thing. Susan, can you get me a 2 coffees and 2 green teas, please, when you get a chance? Over the phone. And then,
magenta.
Wasn't there a bulldog one, too?
I think that was magenta.
That's what everyone's going to sound like on the phone now. I'm never narrating a phone conversation again.
Yes. Yeah, there was one named chartreuse. Go on.
And baby paprika.
I remember paprika and salt and pepper. I remember the condiments, not the animals.
Detective.
She's trying to turn the stream
hellish
off.
Hellish life of. Oh, thank you, detective.
Detective.
She sits down. You brought your beverages, and just so. I spent better part of the evening and this morning looking over the evidence that you provided. This is some pretty heavy stuff, I will say.
Yeah, it was super intense.
Here. Yeah, obviously the threat of attacks on our office, as well as other key parts of Ward 47 infrastructure, notwithstanding, we can report those to administration and see if anyway, if they'll step in and can stop any of it. So first things first, your arraignment on Monday. I think we have what we need here. I've got one of my partners is currently conferencing with the prosecutor on another case and is going to be presenting some of this to him today, and we'll see whether their office would be willing to drop the charges based on what we provided. I should be hearing from them pretty soon, so hopefully I'll have an answer for you before you leave here today, and we'll have good news. I wanted to discuss some other elements of what you found as well. I'm concerned, obviously, with some of the people at play here in this silence organization. Did you hear anything, or was there anything outside of the audio and video records that you can provide for me? Or was this it?
Mori will pull out that check and slide it over. Name and address.
Okay. That's Mr. Fowler, correct? Yes. I was able to, off the video you sent, pulled some strings and was able to identify him. So that's good that we have this. I don't know if I should ask why you have a check for $10,000.
Not if you don't have to.
I don't have to, and you can have this check. We have the footage that we need.
Just folds it and puts it back. We
can obviously, based on the voice recognition between the silence meeting that you oversaw and the audio and video from outside of the meeting and the phone call that you provided, I think there's a lot there to show that Mr. Fowler has this involvement. The silence, connecting it with some sort of credible conspiracy to commit these acts of terrorism. So the problem we're going to run into is I think it's enough to get you off the hook for this. I can't see a prosecutor going to touch this with a 10-foot pole at this point. This is pretty definitive, and I think we get this thrown out very easily at this point. As for bringing up charges against Mr. Fowler, that is a separate issue. I don't know if the prosecutor is going to take that off of this evidence that we have. And honestly, given Mr. Fowler's relationship with Sinocorp, I highly doubt that they will want to bring up charges.
What is his relationship to Sinocorp?
He is... Actually, let me bring up my notes too, so I have that. Mr. Fowler works in their acquisitions department. Not a high level member of the organization by any means, but he works in their marketing and sales department, mid-level office worker, manages a small team there. No one important to the corporation, and I'm sure they would hang him out to dry if we had enough evidence, but they're pretty tight on defending their own and keeping their business out of the public eye. I would say it's very likely that the prosecutor won't want to draw the ire of CinnoCorp trying to bring up charges against them, especially with a case as tenuous as what we are presenting them with. So, whether this is going to stop what is going on, unfortunately, I don't think this will be enough for that. But that's also not really what we're here for, obviously, given we are a defense firm, might dabbling in some contract and law as well. What I wanted to discuss with you, and she kind of looks down at the phone for a second and like double checking, making sure like nothing's recording or that it's not on. She said, and she moves a little bit closer to y'all on the table. You all took a pretty big risk in doing this, a little more hands-on than my usual clients would be. I'd like to put you in contact with someone.
Who?
So we are not strictly speaking affiliated with this group, and off the record, this goes outside of any sort of client, attorney-client relationship. Simply as one private citizen speaking to another. We work very hard here, and those of us at Andrews, Baird, and Klein take the well-being of the ward very seriously, as well as its residents. Specifically, its Parsling residents. There are other organizations within the ward that seek to do the same in a less official capacity. We had mentioned to you yesterday, or I had mentioned to you yesterday, Amaris, when you called, that we had some contacts who could help with some security for our firm, people that we could reach out to. These are the same people. They help protect our clients when needed. In fact, we had originally reached out to them to provide, keep an eye on the four of you, to provide you protection during this case, though it didn't seem like you, doesn't seem like you've needed it very much. They refer to themselves as Babel.
Like talking or like the tower?
Both.
They have a tower?
Well, no, it's a historical reference.
I don't know, actually. Again, we keep our relationship pretty disconnected, given we want plausible deniability in anything they do, but we do represent some of their clients if they do have any run-ins with the law.
They're Parslings, aren't they?
Yes.
Well, I'm happy to be in contact with them, but I can't make any promises as far as becoming affiliated with them or working with them. What we did yesterday was kind of drastic, and I think it's going to be more of a one-time thing.
Of course. Let me, if you want to meet with them and give the go, if you would like to speak with them, then you are free to do so. One of their representatives is currently here. Well, the sort of leader of their group is willing to meet with you here today, if you would like. But if you wish to walk away from all of this, no hard feelings. I'm simply here providing a chance to do something bigger within the ward. I'm not a recruiter or anything by any means. Like I said, this is kind of outside of what I normally do, considering the people I'm representing are usually pretty scared and aren't really taking things into their own hands as much. But the three of you demonstrated a willingness to get things done.
There's four of us. Amaris is here.
Oh, four of you. Sorry. Kind of shrunk into the corner. The four of you demonstrated a willingness to get things done that I don't normally see. And you did draw some attention through that.
Mori grimaces.
That happens.
Don't
me
get
a
me
wrong.
Amaris don't. Somehow disappears even more.
don't get me wrong. The idea of an organization that's specifically looking out for parcelings, that's really quite remarkable. Admirable, even. He like takes a moment and his eyes just sort of sparkle, and then he like clears his throat. But like I said, yesterday was a bit much.
But I mean, Mori, you helped like make the ward, right?
In part, yes.
Shouldn't you be, like, first in line to help protect it?
Yes, absolutely.
I want to meet them.
Would the rest of you like to meet them as well? No commitments if you meet them. But
Mori's gonna glance at Amaris. Is she looking like hesitant or like?
When is she not?
Very uncomfortable.
Can she be perceived?
She looked a little deer in the headlights, and then Aiden said he wanted to meet with them. She kind of looked, then looked between the other two of you. Yeah, whatever, we can talk to them or something.
At Amaris's agreement, Mori says quietly and quickly, yes, I would very much like to meet them.
Okay.
Aiden looks extremely pleased.
she stands up and heads to there's like the glass windows that the conference room can see out to the office, and she sort of pulls the blinds shut. She says, I'm going to step out for your meeting. Obviously, deniability, like I said. But I will be back after you're done speaking so we can discuss legal matters. I'm going to follow up with my partner as well to see if there's any developments. And she hits a button in the conference. She says, you can come in now. And leaves.
Do they have that really cool thing where you like hit the button and all the office like goes opaque?
Oh yes, that's exactly what happened. Thank you. That's so much better than blinds. yes, the windows go opaque.
Whoa.
And she leaves the room. And there's a few moments of silence. You hear her footsteps receding, and then you hear some footfalls approaching. Clearly different. Sound like more like boots or heavier shoes in comparison to the like business heels that Penny wears. The door opens and a figure enters who immediately says, hello, Mori. As Evelyn enters the room.
Mori, you already know them?
Evelyn!
You know
well,
everybody.
I shouldn't be surprised.
She is again for the chat, for any of you that weren't there. Medium height, black woman with hair kind of pulled back and up. She's wearing a kind of a heavier jacket, boots, and shorts underneath with an unbuttoned like Oxford shirt as well. And she slides in the room, closing the door. She says, "It's a pleasure to finally meet all of you. Yes, I know Mori. We've worked together before."
"I thought I was supposed to get in contact with you."
"Well, you took too long. I sort of work on my own pace, but unfortunately things just sort of worked out the way that we ended up crossing paths again like this. I very much wanted to meet your friends here."
"How do you and Mori know each other?"
"I don't know if that's really my story to tell."
"Yeah, we go way back. We went to school together."
"Right.
School." "I see.
I'm Evelyn. For those of you that haven't met me, I'm a Parsling, same as you."
"Well, the rest of us are too."
"My name's you."
"I believe I've received all of your names. You, Aiden, Amaris. It's a pleasure to meet all of you. Been keeping eyes on the four of you since your unfortunate brush with administration." "You all seem to be very competent. Your detainment a few days back."
"Ah, I see."
"At the time, we had only heard that there were a few Parsings that had been rounded up in another attempt from administration to sweep another silence attack under the rug. And we had reached out, made contact with our council here to see if we could offer our services in helping. And lo and behold, our services weren't needed as much as we thought. You handled yourselves very well in the alleyway against those goons that tried to attack you. And..."
"How do you know about that?"
"As I said, we had members watching, trying to keep eyes on you to keep you safe."
"But you didn't intervene and Aiden got hurt."
"Well..."
"Oh, I'm fine."
"We were in the process. We were in the process of intervening when you dealt with your assailants first."
"It did go down quite quickly. Pretty quick.
Mori here even scaring one of them off before I had a chance to step in."
"It's all smoke and mirrors."
"Wait, Mori scared somebody?"
"Intimidating fella here."
Looks at Dad. Looks very slowly down and back up Dad.
It's casual Friday.
"The most intimidating." She sits down at the table with the four of you. Says, "So, I'm sure you have questions. Or I can give you the spiel first, whichever you prefer."
"I mean, I guess spiel. I'm not exactly sure why you wanted to talk to us."
"Oh yeah, I have no clue what's going on."
"I would very much like it if the four of you would work with our group."
"Like you would pay us to do stuff?"
"Mm-hmm."
Like what?"
"Oh, all sorts of things. We're a pretty small organization. All Parslings here within Ward 47 and some outside of the ward. Trying to keep the peace and in some ways to upset the peace in our favor, obviously.
I don't get it.
Sinocorp has done a lot of work to keep Parslings under wraps, to make it out as a small inconvenience, a parasite, an infection that they can contain within their nice walls here and keep the rest occupants of Sinnoh and the world safe. You all understand that that's a load of bullshit, I assume. You're all Parslings here. You don't drink human blood. You don't transform into monsters and stalk the streets at night.
No, but we did see one of those.
I do tend to stalk the streets, though.
Right. At least you all have a sense of humor.
Oh, I was being serious.
Right. It looks over to Mori like, where did you find these people?
Hey, she wanted to recruit us.
Right. The Parslings that work within our group do all sorts of things. They gather information. They act as a sort of neighborhood watch. They keep people safe. People like us.
Vigilantism.
You could say that.
Well, I don't know. I mean, my neighborhood has a watch, and I don't think I'd call them vigilantes. Well, Rufus, maybe.
How many of the neighborhood watch are Parslings? How many of them would stop a mugging if they knew that the victim was a Parsling?
I don't know.
Difference being that the neighborhood watch is actually licensed to do this.
That too. We're not, obviously. This would be outside of the law. Vigilantism. That's always a difficult word.
That's fine. I tried getting my license and I keep losing it, so.
Right. So that broke my brain a little bit.
You seem like you don't really know where to go from here, and that's probably my fault. I'm sorry. I just kind of say things when they come into my brain before I lose them.
One of the things that we are working towards right now has to do with something that I believe the four of you witnessed last night. Just the rise of incoherence in the ward.
Do you know anything about that?
We've been keeping an eye on it for a bit now. Used to be Parslings, any Parsling, can go incoherent. It happens frequently, unfortunately. People that indulge too much to follow the instincts created by the Parsling are gradually go that route. It happens. It's unfortunate, but for the most part, it's a rare case. We have seen an increase in incoherent attacks, specifically within Ward 47, disproportionate to the number of Parslings that actually reside here. So, either something is driving the Parslings within Ward 47 to go incoherent, or something's creating the incoherence and letting them loose. I'm a believer in the latter.
Cynicor?
Precisely.
Wait, what? You think that Cynocorp is making monsters?
Incoherence. They're not monsters, they're people. People like you and me that have been driven to something that renders them in many ways inhuman.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Didn't we hear about someone was talking about some sort of rumor that when Parcelings get arrested, they do weird experiments on them?
I think Roy told us that.
Okay.
I mean, it was Roy, definitely.
That is a rumor that's been circulating for some time, and I think it has an element of truth to it. I don't know how far up it goes. We don't have any contacts inside of Cynocorp. They're very particular about hiring, and it's very difficult to get hired there as a Parcelling.
My mom works for Cynocorp. Is that a problem?
I was aware of that. No. Not unless it's a problem for you.
I mean, I don't tell my mom everything, so...
Maybe even having someone with some connection on the inside might be good, but we're trying to identify where, how deep this goes and how far up the ladder it goes. So, that would be something I'd be interested in. The four of you assisting on investigating, researching, whatever you want to call it.
Ev, I really appreciate what you're trying to do here. I think it's admirable. It needs to be done. But these guys just got out of trouble with the law. And I don't know if they really want to get back into it.
Would we get in trouble?
I understand that. You could. If Cynocorp caught on to this, if administration learned of our group and found out that you were members, I can't say that they would be too happy about that, and you'd probably face similar legal trouble to what you're facing right now.
But they don't know who you are. You said if.
If.
So obviously, the don't say anything.
Goal of our organization is to remain anonymous.
That one I do
to
know.
To do this in secret. I understand where you're coming from, Mori, but these three here with you are capable of making their own decision. Even if you've given up your goals of being a freedom fighter, maybe the three of them would like their opportunity to do so.
Freedom fighter. Where did you two go to school together?
Again, I will let the four of you work through that on your own later. But I'll say two other things that might get you on board that you might have personal stake in. One is, I believe that the silence is a very clumsy attempt from somebody at Cynocorp to perpetuate some of the hysteria that they've been working so hard to create around Ward 47. I believe that they have direct ties, specifically this Elijah Fowler. It doesn't seem to be a coincidence that he is working as employed with Cynocorp, and I believe that's a potential lead there. Also, we need to stop these attacks from happening. To keep the people here safe. You're familiar with Elijah. You've dealt with him directly at this point. Perhaps you'd be willing to assist in dealing with him directly.
Like how?
I haven't really thought on that too long. I'm not saying you have to murder the man, but we need to get the point across that he can't come into our ward and attack us the way he's been doing.
I'm in.
That's one.
Look, if we don't do it, who's gonna?
My sister did just say I need a better job. Don't think this is what she meant, but... Y'all don't have, like, a uniform or anything, right? Because, like,
that would sort of defeat the purpose of our group.
Cool.
We all do have matching tattoos, though.
Cool.
I think what she means is the parcelings thing.
Oh. It's not a bad idea, though. I just like tattoos. Goes like this. Aiden has a bunch of voluntary tattoos too. What do you guys think? I mean, you don't have to. Is looking at you and Mori if you don't want, but I mean, this is our home. Mori, you built this place.
No, of course. This is all I've ever wanted from Ward 47, is to have somebody looking out for people who have been either ignored or ostracized since the beginning. But it doesn't have to be you. It doesn't have to be any of us. It needs to be done, but I don't want you to feel pressured into this.
I know. What about the rest of us?
That's funny.
Sorry, I had to. Anyway.
I just think that... I mean, if it's something that you've wanted for a long time and no one's done it... Everybody's probably saying the same thing as you are. Something should be done. Somebody should do something. But if everybody's just standing around saying somebody else should do it, no one's ever going to do it, and it's never going to get done. And I want to have a home here where I don't have to hide all the time. I know. I want to have a home here where I don't have to hide all the time. And I want Amaris to be able to come and go without sneaking around, and you to be able to make a home here, and Mori, you to be proud of what you built.
Make a good argument, Aiden.
That was a good speech. I'll write that down. Proceeds to write that down.
You know, I always feel like if you want something, you shouldn't stand around and wait for somebody to bring it to you. Because that's a good way to be disappointed.
I've got nothing better to do.
Hm. Oh, somebody's got to make sure you kids don't get hurt.
You're going to be a freedom fighter again, Mori?
Do you hear the people sing the song of angry men?
No, what? Where?
Ma likes to watch Les Mis. Like, all the time.
I don't know that one.
But this has all been very touching, and I'm happy to hear that you're all going to assist. I suppose we can discuss the details of where you want to start and how you wish to help. Any assistance would be helpful. Mori, there was a bit that I wanted to tell you as well, if you would agree to this. However, I don't wish to divulge more information than you're willing to share with your compatriots here.
I've been meaning to speak with you privately anyhow.
All right. Well, then why don't we step out for 1 second? And I can tell you a bit of what our old college friends are up to these days.
He's just going to stand up wordlessly.
And the two of them step out. And that's where we're going to take our...
Oh.
I do have one quick question before we leave.
I also have a quick thing too. Go
ahead. Hey, Mori. Do you still have that listening device on you?
What? Why? Why would he?
He would have definitely taken it off when he went
home. We haven't turned them back in yet.
Unless someone has snuck it onto him, he does not still have it. He's wearing a new tie today.
Never mind.
I imagine it's sitting in a grocery bag, like on the table, like he was coming to turn it into the...
Fine, we'll do it the old-fashioned way with a fucking cup on the door.
You taps Amaris on the arm as Mori and leaves. All right, so I'm going to level with you. I zoned out there for a really long time. I kind of figured that someone would tell me what's going on eventually.
We're going to do crime.
Crime.
Cool with that?
But, like, good crime.
Yeah, good crime.
Nice.
Cool.
Now we're going to take our break. All right. Thanks, everyone, for watching. We will take a quick break here, and then we will come back in a few minutes to finish our session. So stay tuned. Welcome back, Internet. Thanks for hanging out with us while we took our break. We're gonna jump right back in to where we left off. So I think the most important thing for me to figure out up front is what is everybody in the room doing during this conversation?
Immediately looking for something to listen into this conversation.
What okay, are you looking for?
Okay, I may be overreacting, but I'm pretty sure that they like have a history. So I need to know.
You nods along, takes his cup of tea, pours it into like a potted plant, and hands the cup to Amaris.
Thank you.
Oh, I was done with
mine. It's definitely
mine.
A fake plant.
Could have had mine.
It's a fake plant. Are those rubber ficuses?
Oh no.
It's fine, it'll dry.
Pours it in, looks away, and you just see it like seeping out the bottom of the...
...120% listening in, like the nosy bitch that she is.
Right. We're gonna have the conversation, then we'll roll for a perception to see how much you're picking up.
You brings out me, hands them to Aiden.
Hey, buddy.
Hey.
Aiden starts trying to teach him tricks.
Okay, we'll also roll for that when we get back. Mori, you and Evelyn step out. I'm sorry for the surprise. I mean, not really, but you looked like you were going to blow a gasket for a minute there.
Who all still left?
Well, I suppose it depends on your interpretation of left at this point. I have seen over the past few months Ruby, Tag, Lennox. There could be others out there, but
I thought they were all dead.
Honestly, it might be better if they were. I'm going to level with you here, Mori, and you can share this with your friends in there if you want to. I have a theory. We encountered an incoherent a few weeks back. And okay, normally incoherents are part of the natural progression of a parceling. The parsite inside of us grows, it evolves, it takes in aspects of however it identifies itself. We're still not entirely sure how any of that works, and the people best suited to identify these things all work for Sinocorp. So we're a bit in the dark, but normally it's sort of a natural growth. If your parsite is particularly inclined to, I don't know, eating blueberries, that is only going to get amplified as part of the process. Naturally, you consume more and more until, you know, you go full Willy Wonka and roll around the city streets as a blueberry. But it's a slow process, and it doesn't harm the host. It only amplifies aspects of their personality. They might not be how you remember them, but they are recognizable. We found incoherent that had attacked some people, and we had tried to contain it, to calm it, but it was enraged in a way that I hadn't ever seen before. And when we finally got it under control, unfortunately, it did not survive the process. It looked like it had been experimented on. It had scars and markings on it, modifications to it. Like somebody had poked and prodded and cut at somebody until they had become incoherent.
Is that what happened to them?
I think so.
But listen, just just because you can't see it doesn't mean I haven't been fighting. All right? I have put every ounce of effort that I can into making this place good for us. God. That's where they've been this whole time. Ev, have you ever heard of Memento?
Yes.
Do you have any idea? Have you heard anything recently?
I have. How do you know about Memento?
I'm not proud of how I've spent all of this time. Just know I've put most of it behind me. What have you heard?
That was how I found Tak.
What do you mean?
This memento is, not well known in most circles, but it is. I was trying to make contact with this person to help us to consolidate resources and to see which side they were on. I found out that somebody had been using the name to get into some circles. Circles that I was concerned might indicate Memento being not on our side. I found that they were having a meeting with some members of Silence. I followed, or I staked out the meeting, and that's where I saw Tag.
So he was with this Memento?
Or he was pretending to be Memento, I don't know. Or he is Memento.
Tag?
I don't know. I'll tell you, I was just as shocked as you are right now when I saw him there. I followed, I tried to follow him, and I lost him, so.
He's coherent?
At least coherent enough to not kill people on sight, but I don't think he's... I don't think he's fully so, no.
Not enough for you to be approaching him and not me.
I didn't get close enough to really find that out for myself. But he looked like Tag. But the way he carried himself was different, was... I don't know, it wasn't the same. But I began to have my suspicions about what he was doing and where he had spent the past few years when I ran into Lennox a while later. Lennox, I say I ran into him more that a few members of our group did. And he killed them.
Sorry.
It's part of the job, right? Not a stranger to death at this point. We all understand the risks.
He like quirks an eyebrow back at the door. Do they?
That's for you to discuss with them. They need to know this isn't a safe gig. But it's also not safe to live here. It's not safe to be one of us. They can either live a quiet life for as long as they can until someone comes knocking at their door and the worst comes to worse, or they can do something that matters.
And they can wind up just like Lennox.
Not if I have anything to say about it.
Good. Because if they do, that's on us.
Right. I agree with you there. Just know, well, if you run into any of them, any familiar faces, I know you, Mori. I know you're going to want to try to save them. Do yourself a favor. Do them a favor. Run.
You know, that's the second time you've told me that.
I know I was vague the first time, but now you understand the gravity of what we're working with here.
Yeah, I think I do.
And the young one, Amaris. If her mother really does work for Sinnoh Corp, that might be the best inn that we have here. I don't know what her relationship is and if she is willing to... is actually empathetic to our cause, but... might be the closest lead we have to getting somebody on the inside.
I guess we'll see about that. But I'll give you this. If Tag were Memento, I would know.
Why is that?
I would know. Gonna head back to the door.
Right. I'll give you some time to discuss amongst the four of you. I'll be here if you wish to talk.
I'm sorry. I just had the thought that as Mori turns around, the windows are transparent again and he was looking at him. He presses the button, it turns opaque again.
Alright, so let's do for the eavesdroppers. Let's do perception?
That seems right? Should we all contribute to this?
Do y'all want to? I'll say one person
can I try to help?
Other people can.
Because obviously I'm shit at perception.
Would the transparent window add a plus one?
I have the perceptive trick as well. So whenever you make a perception check to observe, you can ask a minimum of one question regardless of the success is drawn. So.
Okay. All right,
nosy bitch.
Let's so go into your pool. What's your draw for this?
Okay, so it would be what would that be?
Perception
insight?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's six.
Okay.
That's a lot.
And yeah, if y'all want to help, you can help. You can draw two cards. The draw is six, so you need a six or less.
I didn't read those on my deck.
Oh yeah, you should do that.
Oh my god, can you not do that, please?
Woo. And we
keep an eye out for crit fails.
We're good. So we got two, and this would be because this would be spades, right?
Spades.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Because it's insight.
Okay, so I got
you did
my
not
four and my three.
Knock over your green screen?
What is she doing?
She tried to climb it.
Detective
Va. Not everybody can see my Hades art.
It's beautiful.
Thanatos is okay, up there. So you just can't see it.
Fuck yeah.
Just gonna go clip that.
Four and three of spades. So that's a seven. I've also got a diamond in here, which I am totally cool with burning to bring this higher if necessary.
I drew a diamond and I've got like potential and stuff to spend.
I mean, if you wanna, I'm game for
but
that.
But no success. The diamond and the other card was not a matching suit.
No, but I can make it one. Okay. And it's a four, so.
Okay.
So that's seven.
You did you contribute?
I would, but most of my knowledge stuff is still in wounds, so I'll...
It's okay. Okay. You're distracted.
Well, I'll do mine then, so I'll use this diamond, and I'll make this a four of spades.
Okay.
So that's 11.
So that's 11. Okay.
I just feel like Amaris really wants to do this.
Here's what I will... I'll give you because I don't think you get like
not
you don't
everything.
Get like the full conversation.
No, yeah. Of course not.
You get the name monster. You get the name Tag. You hear them talk about Memento. And you
which
hear
she knows she heard him talking about when they did the whole thing. Okay.
Yeah. And then you hear Evelyn mention that some people were killed.
Did she hear her own name?
I will give you a yes to that as your free question there. So yeah, I'll say yes, you do hear.
So she heard that part too.
Yeah, you hear them talking about Amaris.
I hate it when people are talking about me.
Well, why are they talking about you?
I don't know, but I can guess.
And at that point, Mori... turns around, sees you, turn the light back off, and you all scramble back to your seats, I imagine, and then Mori comes in. Sans Evelyn.
Hey, gang.
Hey, boss.
You guys get a chance to talk about all this?
You were watching me sleep on the table.
Oh, I forgot I was going to teach him tricks.
Oh, I forgot you were doing tricks. Do you have animal handling?
Oh, fuck.
There is an animal handling thing, isn't there?
Mm-hmm. There's animal. Yes, there's animal. Animals under conduct, yeah.
There's animals, so you can either play the drums really well, or you can try to train pets.
Or
have one neon animals. Trees.
Or you what?
Why don't you talk to Amaris next time? Because Amaris actually has a three in fucking animals. Not,
no, don't say what? It like that. Don't say it like that.
No.
All right.
No.
Smash that reverse.
No.
That's on the internet forever.
I'm going to take my child and we're leaving.
Nope. It was one of those moments. As soon as it comes out, you want to take it back. I have a three.
On the internet forever now.
You can bet I marked that shit.
God damn it. I have a three in the animals skill.
Okay. What does Aiden have in
one.
Animals? One. Plus?
Plus which one?
What is animals under? Is that under
either charm conduct. Or cunning.
Yep.
I imagine you would use charm.
That's my good one. I have two in that. So I got three.
Okay.
Hey.
Let me try.
Just draw. Just draw us three. Let's see how many successes
you
get
with this.
No, let me try. Bitch, that's five, bitch. That's a five of hearts. But it doesn't do anything
for me. Yeah. Okay. Well, it adds a one. It'll add a
but
one.
But I got one. Yeah. And then that's it.
Okay.
So, funny story about assisting Aiden.
You drew your king.
Oh, God.
Oh, buddy.
Should I put these in wounds or?
No, I'm trying to remember what happens. Okay, so when you draw your king,
it goes back into my deck.
Yes, that will automatically be reshuffled in your deck unless you decide to vent it.
Yeah.
This doesn't seem like an opportune time.
Probably not.
Can I also be teaching you the trick?
What trick were you teaching?
Well, I don't know.
Play dead.
Yeah.
That's why you were asleep on the desk.
The funniest thing about it is that both of your captioners thought you said play dad.
Play dad.
They both said play dad.
But that's
well, you're not here. What are we supposed to do?
I don't think it's going to be a success, obviously.
No, I got one. I didn't get any fucking... I got no diamonds. I got bullshit.
Yeah.
That's fine.
So I imagine it just turns into me rolling around on the table a lot, pushing papers off the edge.
Is that what you're doing, Val? Really? That doesn't seem appropriate.
No, me is doing it. Not you.
I hate this game.
But Val doesn't play you.
I play you.
Who's on first?
Stand back, I'm gonna parse.
It's parson time.
No, that's not the Power Rangers theme. That's Doom. Never mind.
Oh, that's not the Power Rangers theme. That's Doom. Very similar. I'm still giving him.
My eye is twitching.
Snacks. I'm still giving.
Sorry.
The sweet baby animal. Snacks.
Ugh. I'll have made my eye twitch.
Wait.
Can
dogs have pistachios?
He's a fox.
It's a fox. Foxes
well, we're I don't looking think Aiden up. Really knows that. I think Aiden just kind of...
You give a pistachio to me and me dies. The end.
No. I ask Amaris.
They can have nuts.
Can they? Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna, like,
foxes can have nuts.
Bite a pistachio in half. Giving him
at status. This point, Mori comes back in.
That's really
hey,
good.
Gang.
That's roll over, but that's still pretty good. Oh, hey,
I take it you guys didn't have a chance to talk about all of this.
No, we were a little distracted.
I mean, I don't really know what else to talk about, so.
Well, I know where Aiden stands in all of this. I just want you all to know what you're getting into.
Wait, that's the thing, though, is that, like... I don't know. I just... Amaris said that maybe you guys are keeping some secrets. It seems like. That's not exactly what she said, but... That's kind of how it feels.
Who's getting killed?
Well, members of Babel, for one.
Does that have to do with that memento group?
Why are you asking about memento?
You were pretending about it at that meeting, and then you said it again. Dabbling just now?
Memento is a very dangerous criminal. And we should all try to stay away from him.
Well, if he's dangerous, shouldn't we be trying to catch him?
Nobody knows who Memento is.
Somebody's got to. Nobody has nobody.
Who's tag?
She's just going down the list. She doesn't give a shit.
She sure is. Just sort of like blinks, clears his throat. You heard an awful lot of that conversation.
I was eavesdropping. I do.
You
that.
Guys were also right outside the door, so.
Kind of defeats the purpose of speaking privately.
Nothing is ever private in this world anymore.
You guys were like right outside the door.
You hits the button on the desk and the windows turn transparent again, and Eve is probably standing there, or if she's gone, she's gone.
She's getting some coffee.
She's got a cup pressed up to her ear against the window.
Hey. Yeah.
Tag was a friend of mine and Evelyn's. And a long time ago, he got really hurt. A lot of people got hurt. And it could happen again. Don't get me wrong, like... Aiden's right. People should be doing this. But I just want you all to be aware of the risks.
So he got hurt doing this freedom fighter stuff you were talking about.
Yeah.
Here's the thing, though, like, people are already getting hurt. It's not like something that could happen in the future. It's happening now. But I got beat up in an alley. I mean, I gave as good as I got, better than I got, I think, but.
I mean, yeah, you were still standing and they weren't, so I'd say that's better.
That's the idea. But, I mean, if we go in there on Monday and the judge or whoever says, yeah, we get it, you guys didn't do the bomb, you're free to go, that's not going to keep us safe. So I don't really think we're getting ourselves into any more danger than we're already in. And I'd rather do something about it than sit at home and wait for them to find us.
Well, you make a pretty good point.
Thanks.
Why were you talking about me?
Evelyn thinks that your mom would be a really good asset.
Long breath out.
Yeah, see right there. That long breath, that really makes me think that you don't want to have any part of this.
I didn't say that.
Not right now, anyway.
Look. I feel like maybe all of you have, like, better handle or whatever on, like, this whole parceling thing, okay? This is all pretty new, and we had to keep it all secret for my mom's job, and it's a lot, okay? My sister ever talked about is, you know, seeing people either going the full, whatever it was you called it, when they go too far and get really messed up.
Incompetent.
Incoherent.
Illiterate.
Yeah.
Close enough.
Amaris, I mean, Maybe Mori does, but most of us, I don't really think, know what we're doing any more than you do. I don't. I never heard of it incoherent till Mori said it.
Speaking of which, if we are going to do this, we need to work more like a team. Totally. I mean, we did all of the incognito stuff really well.
We should get walkie-talkies.
Not a bad idea. But my point being, we really need to know how to throw down a little bit better.
I have plenty of experience in throwing down.
Yeah, I can help with that.
Oh, good.
I don't like touching people.
I can help with that too. Don't have to. Most martial arts is defensive, though.
My point is, we should work together to make sure that we have a plan for in case we run into another incoherent or pack of silence or any other physical threat.
Okay.
I'm sure Evelyn would be happy to give us some more training on, you know, parceling things. I've got to be honest with you, I speak like I'm an authority on it, but I really haven't been doing this for very long.
Well, now there's four of us, so we'll figure it out way quicker.
You're all sure about this?
Yeah. I'd rather me sort of be in the line of fire than somebody who maybe can't handle it.
All right. Noble sentiment. Maybe a little misguided. But we can work on that.
Oh, I'm also, like, a lot bigger than most people, so.
Right.
That's easier for me to stand in front of them. Like, if Amaris stood behind me, you wouldn't even be able to see her, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
We can't see Amaris good on most days.
Exactly. That's something you're really good at.
I hope you understand that you have more worth than just, you know, a meat shield. Like.
Well, what's wrong with being a meat shield?
You get hit a lot.
So? If I get hit a lot, you don't. I don't see what's wrong with that.
Yeah, but, like, the point of being a team is that, like, we all get hit sometimes so that there isn't just one person getting hit all the time.
No, it doesn't have to be.
And I mean that, theoretically, like, not literally. But also, I don't literally want to see you get hit all the time. Does that make sense?
Yeah. I'd much rather me get hit than you or Amaris. Though you, I think, can take it. But I'm afraid that if you guys ever got hit, you'd just sort of die. Which is something we can totally work on.
I don't know if I've ever gotten hit that hard before.
But, see, that's kind of what I'm just saying, Mori, you're smart and really good at talking to people and finding stuff, and Amaris is, like, great at computers and super good at hiding, and Yu's also really good at finding stuff and kicks and eating noodles and trying new things. And I'm good at fighting. I just want to be useful, you know?
Good assessment of everyone's strengths here.
You puts a hand on Aiden's shoulder. You do the arc good.
Thanks. I don't think it's really gonna help us, like, fight crime, but I'm definitely gonna paint us doing it.
Alright. Well, if we're all in on this, we should probably go and tell Evelyn.
We should have a team name.
Us.
Fuck you, RJ. Oh.
That's how long have you been sitting on that for?
That was a little too quick.
Actually, I wasn't sitting on that very long. The millisecond Savvy said we need a team name.
I knew you would be there for me.
Always.
Dude, that's actually kind of deep.
You know what? We can brainstorm it.
We shouldn't actually use us, because if we introduce ourselves as This Is Us, I think there's some copyright implications there.
I mean, just also you, us. Is we're going to have... like an old movie by Jordan Peele, so yeah.
You work. I think maybe next time we sit down and eat noodles, I want to have a talk with you about the things you do understand about society and the things you don't understand about society. Because just when I think I've figured it out, you freaking throw a curveball at me and start talking about copyright.
Mom likes to talk about copyright infringement a lot.
I was going to say wolves are very litigious.
Right.
Around this time, just sensing the conversation is reaching a near end, Evelyn like knocks on the door and pops it open, says,
I don't want to interrupt if you're still hashing things out, but I sense that it's been a bit, so I'm just checking to make sure everybody's still all right.
No, I think we've reached a decision.
Wonderful. Are you still looking to help out?
Yes. He just sort of like looks at the rest of the group to make sure that he gets confirmation from everyone.
Aiden nods enthusiastically.
Aiden had to go get the ramen off the porch. Yeah, bro, totally. Or, ma'am. Totally.
Let's not do ma'am. You can call me Evelyn. Ev.
Okay.
Captain, I don't care, but one
Captain,
of them, you
know, oh, those Captain's good.
Let's not do that. That was more of a joke. All right, I sort of made a mistake by doing that, didn't I?
Yeah.
But that's what we call Mori.
Call Mori Dad.
I don't think I understand the relationship between the four of you, and honestly, I think I'm okay with that.
Well, Mori's used Dad.
Yeah. Mori? All right.
Are you going to leave this young wolf pup imprinted and alone?
I mean, not biologically. And legally. In fact, I'm not entirely sure how they came to that conclusion.
You just sort of have that air about you, Mori. You know, back in college, people looked to Mori a lot for guidance as well. So
I can totally see you being like
orange slices.
I can totally see you being like a tutor or something.
More like a guidance counselor.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mori in a sweater vest.
Anyway.
So.
You look me in the eye and tell me Mori doesn't own a sweater vest.
Thanks to his closet full of sweater vests.
So many sweater vests.
Hitting that fall chill of sweater vest season.
Oh, hell yeah.
So what do you need from me?
You don't still give self-defense courses. Parslings 101?
That's a good question, actually. How many of you have actually... Start off. How long has each of you been a parsling for? Months, years,
a few seasons
decades.
Now.
So not very long. Less than a year.
A while, but I don't know the full capabilities.
Right. Aiden?
Yeah, that's the thing about me. I don't actually remember.
Oh. All right. Amaris?
About 6 months.
All right. Have any of you parsed before?
Once. We traded hair. Kind of.
Not on purpose.
All right.
It was so cool, though. I had like a cool white. Sorry. I liked it. I wish it would come back.
So none of you have actually formed a paragraph?
I write a little bit of poetry. Does that...
You write poetry?
No, I mean, it's not serious.
We've known each other for a few days.
So we have some tutorials and some... All right. So a bit of educating sounds... I can handle that. We have, you know the old community center on the south side of the ward, the one that they abandoned after construction before they built the new one near Central? We've requisitioned it for some of our activities. It was condemned, so nobody comes snooping around there. Your office might want to look into it at some point, Mori, but maybe after we're done with our business.
Yeah, sorry. No, that one just really flew under the radar.
Well, they had that gas leak, and...
After they built the new one, nobody was really worried about it anymore.
Yeah. Suffice it to say, that performance of... Midsummer Night's Dream got a bit
trippy
out there. Yeah.
I go in there to paint sometimes. You can't stay in there for too long, though. Right. It's fine now, but
we've cleared up the gas leak and have been using it for some training. Do any of you own any weapons?
You pulls out a knife, you pulls out some brass knuckles, you pulls out a wrench.
I forgot you had the
brass
knuckles.
What exactly about me makes you think that I would have a Jesus Christ?
I didn't know you're religious.
I can introduce
you. Well, no, he said, what about me makes you think I would have a Jesus Christ?
Mother Mary.
I can introduce you to, we have a contact that supplies... firearms and other munitions for us. So if you need anything like that.
Whoa, you have guns?
You find that they come pretty pretty handy. Tasers as well. Small weapons, but we're working on getting some bigger ammunition.
What about like...
And train you in that too.
Nunchucks.
If that's what you want, I'm sure I can get you a pair.
What about, like, bow staff?
That's the one that's just a big stick, right?
Yeah.
I could get you one of those.
I don't have any, but I learned how to use them once upon a time.
You'll have to talk to Locke about it when you meet them.
We've already met them.
What?
You have.
At the shop where we did the meeting.
Oh!
Why is your ammunition supplier hosting silence meetings at their shop?
Oh. So you've met Locke. Locke rents out the shop for... Locke rents out the shop for, well, Locke's employer rents out the shop for all sorts of meetings. They're the ones that gave us the inside track to some of the silence gatherings that we've been observing.
I did not make a good first impression with them.
Well, there's the chance for a second first impression.
You were also... Oh no, you weren't wearing your mask yet. Never mind.
Locke is a bit
temperamental. Doesn't like to be put out. But it's very good at getting their hands on things.
I'll keep that in mind.
All right. So we meet them. Maybe, how about tomorrow? We all rejoin, and you can meet me over at the community center, and we can do a bit of training. Discuss how we want to proceed. I can gauge a bit of your skills.
Yeah, right. That means I don't have to walk all the way to the gym.
So what sort of training are we going to be doing here? Should we just come as we are, or is this a sweatpants sort of thing?
I'd probably lose the loafers, trade up for some tennis shoes.
Well, gotcha. Depending on what we're doing, you're probably going to want something more close-fitting than sweatpants, just because it's pretty... You don't want to give people a lot of stuff to grab onto, you know?
No.
Sorry.
Looks dead on Evelyn, like, corseted black dress with mermaid at the bottom. Right.
Leggings would be good, actually. And you get those in black.
Okay, sure.
All right. Yeah, come dressed for in workout attire and prepare for a training montage.
This is so cool.
And we'll discuss parsing as well, because that's something you're going to want to know how to do effectively. You can talk to Mori about that. Well, I'm excited, and I believe your attorney is looking to speak with you, so Mori has my contact information, and you all can reach out to me if you need anything.
It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too.
Bye.
Good seeing you again, Ev.
See you too. And she steps out just as Penny ducks in, kind of gives a brief nod to Evelyn as she leaves and says, "Hey, all right. That's all between the five of you. Wanted to just give a brief update. I received an update from my partner, Anders. The prosecutor took our deal. They are dropping the charges against the four of you.
So we don't even have to go to the thing on Monday?
Nope, not at all. We'll make an appearance. I'll make an appearance on your behalf before the judge to make sure that the case is dismissed, but the four of you are good to go.
Great.
Amaris actually smiles.
Does that mean we can go get lunch now?
Does that mean I can go home?
Yes. Yeah, you can leave the ward now if you wish.
Hey, that's awesome.
All of you can, obviously. Your movement should no longer be restricted. So, obviously, this is the best part of my job that I can say. I hope that we don't have to see each other again. But if you ever need representation, know that we are here. Any point in the future. All right.
Thank you, Ms. Baird.
Of course.
Yeah, thanks, Penny.
You pokes Aiden on the shoulder to ask for his phone.
Just hands it.
Goes on Yelp, 5 stars, shows Penny, hits submit, and gives it back to Aiden.
Good thinking.
Thank you.
Good thinking.
Means a lot in our business. Well,
if you need the conference room for anything else, you can certainly stay here. But it's been a pleasure working with all of you.
Yeah, totally.
Thanks for all your hard work, Miss Baird.
Of course. And she'll step out, leaving the four of you to go get lunch.
Noodles?
All y'all eat is noodles.
There's a lot of different kinds of noodles.
As you all leave to heading down the street to go get lunch, we will leave on one little scene. Across the city, many blocks away from where you currently are, there is a flash of red lights atop a dark tinted vehicle with a Sinnoh City Department of Administration logo painted across the side. The door pops open and out steps Administrator Roy, who you had met previously. Actually forgot his last name because I just told y'all to call him Roy. West. Administrator West. Leroy West. He steps out of the vehicle with a couple of other administrators and looks over a small two-story apartment building. Kind of sighs through the mask that he wears and steps out the building. Currently, there is a small crowd of people gathered outside watching and taking videos on their phones, and a group of investigators in like hazmat suits that are leaving the building taking off masks. One of them walks up to Roy and says, it seems to be all cleared, sir. Levels have returned to normal state. Haven't identified the toxin yet, but we're sending residue samples back to the lab for identification. He gives a nod and says, thank you. I'll take the full report later. He steps up into the front entryway and stops for a second, sighing, and then stepping into the building. And as he slowly walks inside, peering down the corridor and into rooms, as he passes open apartment doorways, there's a stillness in the air as in each residence you can see, he witnesses medics currently zipping up body bags and beginning to load them onto gurneys. He stops outside one of them as a few are loaded out and pauses as he stoops down and looks at the door and looks at the bottom of the wall. There's a long scrape and then a dark greenish black inky residue that is streaked across the wall. He picks up the phone, his phone out of his pocket, presses a button, and puts it to his ear. After a few seconds, he says, yeah, it's me. We have another one. All right. I'll get to work. Hangs up. Puts in his pocket and stands to leave. That's where we're going to end our session for tonight. Alrighty. Next mystery afoot, y'all.
Guys, I keep forgetting that we only play for 3 hours. And the ending hits me so hard. It's like, wait, we're done? What? No.
Yeah, the halfway, the break during this time hit me so quick. I looked down. I was like, oh, we've only been playing for 30 minutes. It's 5:30. Oh, no, wait, we start 4 Central Time. Never mind.
Central Time.
All right, let's do our end of session stuff, y'all. A lot happened today. Y'all finished kind of your first little thing here. I don't know what to call it. It's not a mystery. Not quite a mystery.
You can call it a short-term mission. Goal.
Yeah. Where's my script criteria? Alrighty. First question, or first one. Everybody gets a point of script for attending.
Woohoo!
I'll get one. Second, each character has learned something new or experienced character growth gains one script. I feel like you all have.
Yeah.
At least learned something new.
Yeah.
So, whether you've grown as a person is up to you to decide.
Oh no, I'm laughing at Aiden going, I gotta sit you down and figure out what you actually fucking know.
Yeah, it is all over the board and I love it.
Yeah, I'm glad somebody finally said it because like
So good.
Heroism, I don't think we really got into today. Each character commits a heroic feats of survival persistence with the intent of saving others.
I talked about doing them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we
from
talked
the safety
about
of my
stuff,
attorney's but... office.
Very heroic speech.
We're going to be getting into more heroism as y'all have now gotten involved with Babel. Y'all are going to go full on vigilantes, and I'm excited for it. Wisdom. Each character presents a plan or solution that drastically alters the fate of the party gains one script. I'm trying to decide whether...
I said we should eavesdrop on Mori. Which led to a Aiden lot of said, information that no. Mori was not going to divulge.
Aiden said we should be vigilantes, and here's why.
Yeah, I mean, you all kind of, like, you didn't really present the plan, but you all, like, okayed, like, us doing this that's going to, you know, drastically change. If y'all had all said, you know, no, I don't really want to be a part of this and walked away, it would have drastically been different, the rest of your fate, so... And I was prepared for that, too. I was prepared that Amaris just might be like, nope, I want nothing to do with this, and just, like, peace out. But
and that's when the missile hits the office.
That would have definitely complicated things, so I'm glad it didn't go that way. We didn't have any grave failures or critical successes today, did we?
No.
Right?
Nah.
And then achieving goals. When a character achieves their goals to the satisfaction of the GM, they gain a line of script.
We cleared our name.
Yeah, I think we achieved a goal today.
Yeah, did everybody achieve their short-term goal at this point or still working on it?
I've done one of my two.
Okay, yeah.
I haven't done a parse yet.
Oh, it's a coming. We'll probably legitimately have a training montage next session and probably like a couple. We'll probably like span like a more significant length of time during the next session to give y'all, because I don't really want to be like, you meet with Evelyn for one day and now you understand parsing and how to use guns, because that doesn't seem realistic.
Give you a gun.
Y'all
I'm
can have one.
No, I'm very excited for the training montage because Aiden, I think the one sort of memory he probably has is muscle memory, right?
Yeah.
Wait. I have questions now.
I'm really excited to find out Aiden's Jason Bourne like backstory and then, like,
so good.
Or is it gonna be so Aiden? Good? What's that movie where the guy's a sleeper agent with
Isn't that Jason Bourne?
No. There's one where he works in a convenience store and some guys come after him and he like murks all of them. He calls his girlfriend who's
I know what you're talking about. I don't remember.
I'll look up the movie.
Is it a younger guy that's
it's a
like the lead?
Guy.
Yeah,
is it Michael
I know what...
Cera?
Is it Jesse Eisenberg?
It might be Jesse Eisenberg, actually. Eisenberg, Winklevoss.
Sounds like a Jesse
rowing.
Eisenberg movie.
So, yeah, you get the points for that. And then let's do Stars and Wishes, and then I'll give out the quote for the best.
American Ultra.
That, yeah, because that's the one that has Kristen Stewart in it, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen that.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
I don't think I've seen it, but I think I remember the premise of it. All right, let's do Stars and Wishes, starting with Savannah.
Oh, fuck. I have to go first?
Yep.
Always.
My star is going to go to Mori for doing his best to protect all of his children, even if it means they have to sit down with him and go, no, actually, we want to do this, and you're holding us back a little bit. He's trying his best, and I really appreciate that about him. And that whole conversation was really fun for me personally. I'd be like, listen, we know you're really smart, but also, like, we should be doing stuff. I just like how Mori handled it. It was really fun. My wish is just for training montage. I just want to do that immediately.
Okay. Right now. Part two.
Let's right now!
Wonderful.
Do I have to say a quote? Do I have to say a quote? Do we do those separately, or can I say one that I liked?
I mean, if you haven't added it to the sheet.
No, you know I didn't remember to do that.
Put it on the sheet, because I'm going to I look at those to decide which one is the...
Then I'll keep it a secret.
Go ahead and put it on the sheet right now.
Time to go be the nosy bitch.
All right, so training montage is wish. All right. Who's next?
That's me.
RJ, yeah.
Okay, stars and wishes. Fuck, there was a lot of good moments. Star to Aiden for being the heart of the party. Putting the speech like... Yeah, guys, we live here. We gotta protect it. And I also am the body shield because I don't want anyone being hurt. No, you don't understand, Aiden. We don't want you hurt. We will body block our tank. wishes. Two wishes. One, I want to meet more NPCs because so far everyone's been so fucking fantastic, Val.
Oh, thank
and
you.
The second one is training montage. Aiden and Iron.
I have so many more NPCs that y'all haven't met yet. I'm very excited about. So it's gonna be fun. And training montage times two. I love that you're all doing wishes for something that I've like very much keyed up for the next session. But that makes me very happy that I'm gonna be able to resolve all y'all's wishes right away.
Instant perfect. Gratification.
Awesome. Sid, I think you're next.
Oh man, there was such good stuff.
I'm gonna turn right around on you, Val, and say my star is to Val for bringing in the lovely little moment of being able to talk to my sister and all of the emotional beautiness. Thank you. That was fun. I enjoyed that, actually. That was great. And of course, oh my god, I was gonna cry, Savvy. I was gonna cry when Aiden was being all heroic and shit. Awesome.
He's just simple.
He's just straight. Also, drop the bomb that he writes poetry. Okay. Yeah, don't think you're getting out of that one.
It seemed like an appropriate time.
yeah, they're having that combo. And my wish, I mean, we kind of already gotten it because we have like, what, like four different fucking organizations that are either parcelings, not parcelings, hate parcelings. Now we got a new one, the spoken and the silence and oh, I love it. So
I think y'all have officially met every organization that I've created, except for Sinnoh Court. Well, you met administration. So
true. So I guess I'm going to be very unoriginal and just second everybody else's wishes, which is of course training montage. I cannot freaking wait. And then also more NPCs because they're fantastic.
Yeah, a part of bringing your sister in today is like, one, I was like, somebody's going to wonder where Amaris is. Like, I know we had talked about texting before, but we also hadn't met any NPCs from Amaris' backstory yet. So I was like, I want to bring one of them in to the meat, so I was very happy about that.
And
last up is wings.
My star is for very good hero boy Aiden, for his heroic speech, because god damn it, I was really banking on a heroic speech. I was all like, if I'm gonna be so gung-ho and say like, no, we should not do the thing the DM wants us to do, I was really hoping that somebody would oppose me on that.
Could you imagine that? Well, was like, nah, we're good.
Yeah, it's all like, yeah, actually, Mori's right. We should go with him. And I'm like, no, you simple fools.
That felt like a really big alley-oop moment when you set that up, and then Savannah came in with Aiden being like, I liked that.
I'll be your setter any day. That was perfect. My goal is the same as my wish, so I shall say them together. I want to track down the fake memento. I want to track him down and confront him. This is my goal, and also my wish. I wish to find him and also get script for doing so.
Perfect. Awesome. Okay, so I have some really good quotes from this session that I want to give so many of them out. I will read off some of them. Which is you saying you won't beat me to the spoonful of sriracha. Amaris saying time to be a nosy bitch. Or I guess I didn't know if that was Sid or Amaris when that got said, but
it was both, let's be perfectly honest. Yeah.
Aiden saying nobody is nobody. And then coffee is what unites us in a terrible, terrible place. But I think I am gonna give it to you because it also like it exemplified the like theme of this session a little bit, which is Mori saying if anything happens to them, it's on us. Like that was a very good, I mean, that like fully like encapsulated the session with y'all deciding to join Babel and everything. Like it works on many levels. I know at that moment it was being referred to as the three babies of the group, but it's very good. So and I think that'll be an awesome quote to have on a card too. You just gotta decide what card you're gonna put it on. Mori, you can take that, put your quote down, and gain a script for that. Wonderful. I have to say once again,
I'm gonna put it on a club because Mori so rarely fights.
But it's a common
fight for the kids.
Yeah. I have to say once again that I really appreciate y'all for doing the quotes and consolidating them, because so many good things get said during the session. I'm like, yeah, fuck yeah. And then I'm in GM brain and I'm like doing a bunch of other stuff and I don't even think about writing them down. So that really helps me out a lot. But yeah, that's it for our session, everyone. And we're a little over, but not as bad as we've been before. So thanks everyone for watching and talking and stuff. We will be back in 1 week next Saturday, same time, same place, to continue our game, and we would love to have you join us there again to do the ding dang game more, for training montage and other stuff. I'm sure it's going to be a good one. Join us in a bit, actually. Sure, we're going to go choke down some food. And
did you all order ramen too? Because I totally just ordered ramen.
Yeah, we did get ramen. It's waiting for us, and I'm so hungry. We're going to go eat some delicious noodles, and then Savannah and I will come back for we're going to be playing Dark Souls 3. Or I'm going to be playing it, and Savannah's going to be calling me a scrub. And
I'm going to occasionally say, here, let me try.
Yeah. So we're going to be playing that for a bit because we felt like it'd be fun. And then tomorrow at 4 o'clock Eastern time, we will be back playing Fucked Up Little Guys, which is the
new Dark Souls inspired one-page, one-shot.
Yeah, new Grant Howitt one-page RPG where you're playing as NPCs in a Dark Souls world. So it's going to be really fun.
The premise of it is that you end every sentence with
I'm so excited for it, but thank you everyone out there for watching. Thank you my lovely players here for making this game a joy to run. We'll see everybody next week, and until next time, good game and good night, internet.
sing me.